Hey, weird war weirdos, it's Brian again. It's Monday for another episode of Shit on My Table. All right, so today we're going to go through my civilian vehicles and the update for Mini War Mutt's painting challenge. I'm going to show off all the shit that I've painted this month so far. He's catching up, though. I know he's got a bunch of gremlins in his basement that he's fucking like enchained to help paint all this shit. You know what you're doing, Brian. I know what you're doing. No bueno. All right, guys, let's check it out. All right, guys, so this is what I've finished painting so far this month. Okay? We've got a Chinese giantess superhero. And then we've got a bunch of Chinese guys. We got Chinese light machine gun teams, a Dare to Die dude, and some knee mortars. I did four like little tree men dudes for my latest episode. Or my last video from Fear of the Dark. That's what those are. Reaper. Those are Reaper minis. These are all Eureka minis. And then that is a Super Figs. All right. Then back here, we got a whole bunch of Japs. Japs, Japs, Japs.
That's crazy!
So check this out, guys. So I'm going to put this to you guys. So I was on a modeling, like a model kit company, a model kit site, channel, whatever on YouTube, right? And I was talking about whatever. And I said, hey, man, I'm doing a couple Jap fighters. I need some help, whatever. And one of the British guys just started wigging the fuck out saying like, that's racist, Japanese, it's Japanese, not Jap, you racist. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, dude, if I called, you're British, right? If I called you a Brit, am I racist? And first of all, Japan isn't a fucking race. Just like Britain isn't a race. So if I call you a Brit or a Jap, I'm just nicknaming the country. It's just, anyway, bunch of dumbass, just insanity. Anyway, so these are Japs, not in any racial slur. It's just to identify the nation that they're from. But anyways, all right, so we got four suicide troopers. Then we got a flamethrower, two flamethrowers. We got two snipers. We got two anti-tank rifle teams. We got four suicide lunge mine dudes. We got, what do we got here? We got two knee mortar teams. We got one of my druids. That didn't come out very good. He's covered in bugs, guys. I didn't know how to paint. I painted all these different colors and shit, but it didn't come out after I did a wash on it. But anyway, and then a whole shit ton of infantry. So there's what? There's 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 12, 13, 14 infantry. Then we got four undead zombies, or there's five zombies there. And then these are those, power armor Japs with, those are fucking awesome. And then I did three superhero dudes, Japanese superheroes. And then I did a type one, 40mm anti-tank gun and its crew. And then I did a pilot, and then I did two type 92 battalion guns and crew. There you go. And most of the infantry are warlord or the assault group. The Jep zombies, those are Brother Vinny. The power armor troops are K. I'll have the logo up there. Let you guys check it out. The superheroes are minifigs. The artillery are all warlord, and that samurai, or not samurai, but that pilot is Brother Vinny. So there you go. That's what I got going so far. That's quite a few. I should break 100 before the month's up. So that's what I'm shooting for, guys. Finish up 100 things. That's a shit ton for me. So if you guys are interested, join us. I know it's kind of midway through the month, but it doesn't matter. This is all just for fun. Mini War Mutt, his painting challenge. All right. All right, so let's get to the cool civilian shit.
All right, guys. So this is my civilian vehicles here. All right, so here we got an Asian cart with some Asian civilians on it, with a doing like a water buffalo. I don't know. I got this. A buddy of mine gave me all of his Vietnam stuff, and I sold most of it, but I kept that because that's cool, because that could be used for World War II easy. It's got like a couple kids in the back, like riding. We got a couple like Asian hand carts. Then we just got some general carts. I believe, I want to say that's, oh man, I don't know. Old Glory maybe, or I don't know who did that one. These are a PDF. I want to say that's Foreground. This is from Precision Models. And then that is a Reaper, that little cart. All right, so now this is going to be challenging because I don't know, like, most of these vehicles. But, you know, we got, like, a cool trash. A lot of these are die-cast toys. Most of these are either 150 scale, 148, or 143, okay? Those are the scales of all these trucks and cars and shit. So, all right, so we got a cool little truck here. I would tell you what they are, but I can't fucking read. I don't have my glasses. But yeah, so we got a little truck, a little moving van. We got a cool little passenger bus. We got a little cargo truck. This right here, that's the car I'm using for Black Beauty for my Green Hornet and Kato. Black Hornet. Then we got a couple. We got a tractor, John Deere tractor. It's pretty sweet. Let me grab a mini so you guys can tell the. So like here is a assault group. So that fits like perfect, dude. See, these all fit. See, that fits great for 28 millimeter stuff. Then back here we got a cop car. Then we just got some cool ass, you know, civilian vehicles. We got a fire truck. And we got more civvy vehicles here. This one was just used in our, Fear the Dark campaign. That is Samantha's husband's car. It's a 1930, I forgot what it's called. I looked it up. Anyway, that's a 1930 something or other. Then we got some more cars. Check it out. We got the Mystery Machine. Hell yeah, dude. Then we got a couple 3D printed cars. Check these now. I cannot remember who gave me these STLs. Great guy sent me some STLs to show. I need to paint these up because these are really kick-ass little 3D resin vehicles. You can check this fuck. And these are like real. I guess these are actual real vehicles, like in the 30s, 20s, and 30s that were actually made. So I guess maybe some of them might have been like what concepts, but I think most of them were actually made. That's a cool. That could be. You can make that. I don't know what. That's fucking awesome. That reminds me of like a Flash Gordon, like one of those like rockets or something. But it's really, these are great. But yeah, so there you go. There's all my civvy stuff. Again, I would say most of these are Solito or Matchbox or, Mayflower. There might be some, I don't know. But these are also, I don't want to leave you guys, you know, in the lurch there. So what you do, go on eBay, look up, you know, go to the diecast car section and just plug in
148 or 143 or 150 scale. And then you'll get a whole shitload of stuff. A lot of it is modern day stuff, but they'll have, you know, they'll have, you know, stuff appropriate to this time period. Also, some of this stuff I got at like the dollar store, right, a grocery store. They just they were selling cars, and as a suggestion, all you war gamers, put a mini, you know, put a metal mini, a slotted based metal mini on your keychain, and just keep that with you at all times. So like when you go to the grocery store and there's a bunch of old cars that are for sale for like nothing, you can put that mini up to it and see if it scales right to your shit.
That's what I do. All right, guys.
Well, I hope you guys dug it. Again, eBay is your buddy when you're looking for, you know, cars. Again, I wouldn't look for them in, like, you know, wargaming or models. Go to the diecast. That seems to be where a lot of the good stuff's at. I guess you could do 148 scale cars and stuff would work. But again, why build something when you can just buy a cool ass diecast car and they actually move? Doors open. You can, like, you pull them back and they drive forward. You can actually have real movement in your gaming. But all right, guys. So that is Weird War or Shit on My Table. And if you guys are interested, jump into Mini War Mutt's Painting Challenge. I'll put a link to that punk ass. It'll be down there in the description. He's a cocky bastard. He was like not doing anything, and all of a sudden he had this super painting deluge going on, and he painted a whole bunch of shit. So he's like that. He's a sneaky mother. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Whatever you do in this crazy, crazy mixed up world, keep it weird. See ya. You wanna be a hero?